A security light system is used by a factory. The light only comes on when it is dark and when movement is detected. The light will stay on for 1 minute before switching off. Sensors and a microprocessor are used to control the security light system. Question A says, identify two sensors that would be used in the security light system. To answer this question, we can take a look at the initial paragraph. They tell us that the light is only going to come on when it is dark and when movement is detected. We would need two separate sensors to detect each of these. If we want to detect whether it is light or dark, we would use a light sensor. And if we'd want to detect movements, we would use a motion sensor. Question B says, describe how the sensors and the microprocessor control the security light system. To answer this question, we're going to use our SCAR acronym. The first step is to mention how the sensor sends data to the ADC and to the microprocessor. The second step is how the microprocessor compares the data between stored values. The third step is to mention the action from the result of this comparison. And the last step is to mention that the entire process repeats. To further understand this question, let's draw a diagram containing all of the components of the system. The first part of the system, we have two sensors, the light sensor and the motion sensor, that send data through an ADC. The ADC is an analog to digital converter, which will take this analog data and convert it into data that can be read by the microprocessor. The microprocessor will then compare the values from the light sensor and the motion sensor to stored values from the second step of the process. If the light sensor has a low enough reading, in other words, it is dark, and also the motion sensor detects movement, the microprocessor will then send a signal to the light bulb to switch it on. The question says that the light will stay on for 1 minute before switching off. So when the microprocessor sends the signal to the light bulb, it will also send a signal to a timer to begin the 1 minute countdown. Once the timer is complete, it will send a signal to the light to turn it off. Lastly, the system repeats. In other words, the sensors send data to the microprocessor continuously. Let's go ahead and formulate our answer, which is for 8 marks, meaning we need to put 8 points down. The first step is to mention how the sensor sends data through the ADC to the microprocessor. We can say that sensors send data to the ADCs, which convert the analog data to digital. This digital data is sent to the microprocessor. The second step is to mention the comparison between the stored values. We can say that the microprocessor compares data to stored values. We then want to mention what the action is from the result of this comparison. There are two possible outcomes. Either the light is going to switch on or nothing happens. We need to explain the scenarios in which those two actions occur. First off, if the values from the sensors are within the range of the stored values, no action is taken. Important to note this and in the question, which infers that it must be dark and movement must be detected. So both sensors need to be outside of the range of the stored values. If both values are within the range, the microprocessor sends a signal to switch the light on and a 1 minute timer is started. When the timer reaches 1 minute, a signal is sent to switch the light off. Important to note that the microprocessor is sending all these signals, even though the diagram indicates that the timer is sending those signals. The last thing to mention is that the process repeats. In other words, the sensor is continuously sending data. So let's write that in. And we can say that the whole process is continuous. And there we go. That is the 8 mark answer to complete this question.